We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Hello dear students, myself Dr. Damayanti G. Badkha, Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department from S.N. Patel Institute of Technology and Research Center, Umrah Babin, having Institute Code 049. Today we are going to learn from your subject Mechanics of Solid having subject code 3130608. From B third semester civil engineering branch. So today we will go with the topic introduction, which is available in your GTU B third semester syllabus of civil engineering under mechanics of solid subject. Dear students, to understand mechanics of solid mechanics, strength of material, structural analysis, and there are many subjects. To understand the fundamental of that subject, we should know some introductory part, which will be helpful to understand remaining subject based on that. So in introduction we are going to discuss that mechanics. What is mechanics? Mechanics is the branch of sciences. So which branch? Like applied mechanics. What is applied mechanics? Application of mechanics to engineering problem. Problem may be any problem, like mechanics of rigid body, mechanics of deformable bodies, mechanics of fluids. Okay, so you can say under applied mechanics there are 3 sub part: mechanics of rigid body, mechanics of deformable bodies, mechanics of fluids. But if we'll talk about the mechanics of rigid body, which is our main concern, then there are 2 sub parts of mechanics of rigid body. Which are that parts? Statics and dynamics. Now there is again question, what is statics and what is dynamics? Because it is very fundamental to understand our subjects. So statics means body at rest, and dynamics means body in motion. So here we are going to discuss about dynamics. So in dynamics there are 2 parts: kinetics and kinematics. So what is kinetics and kinematics, which is I clearly mentioned in PPT. You just read over here. Study of motion of body and forces responsible for the motion. This is for kinetics. And for kinematics, study of motion of a body, causes of motion are not studied. Now under this subject we have to focus on statics, dynamics, kinetics, kinematics. So for that we should understand the fundamental of these terms. So what is statics? Statics deals with forces and their effects while acting upon the bodies at rest. Dear students, focus on the word and terms. What is statics? Deals with forces and their effects while acting upon the bodies at rest. And dynamics? Dynamics deals with the forces and their effects while acting upon the bodies in motion. So as per that previous chart, we can say that bodies at rest in statics and bodies in motion in dynamics. If we will talk about kinetics and kinematics as per previous chart, then kinetics deals with the bodies in motion due to application of forces, and in kinematics deals with The body is in motion without any reference to the forces which are responsible for the motion. Now, what are the fundamental concepts we have to discuss? So, space, time, and there are many more which we will discuss in next slide. But if we'll focus on space and time, then under space. Space is the region in all directions and contains everything within. Okay, this is called space. If we'll consider time, then it is a measure of duration between successive events. Now, matter, body, inertia, mass, rest, these all are very important to understand because based on that we have to learn many topics and many subjects. So what is matter? The substance that possesses weight, occupies space, and that can be apprehended by sense is called matter. Now what is body? The matter bounded by a closed surface is called body. Earth is a best example of body, right? Now what is inertia? It is the property by virtue of which a body offers resistance to any change of its state of rest or motion. If we will talk about mass, then the quantity of matter contained by a body is called mass of the body. Now, what is rest? A body is said to be at rest if it does not change its position with respect to a reference point at different interval of time. These all term matter, body, inertia, mass, rest will be helpful to understand the subjects. So we'll talk about motion, then it is very simple from this word. A body is said to be in motion if it changes its position with respect to a reference point at different interval of time. Now, if we idealization in mechanics, then what we have to consider in mind, like particle, rigid body, deformable body, and there are other points too, but we will discuss in next slide. So under idealizations in mechanics, we have to focus on first particle. So what is particle? It is an idealized body which may have negligible mass and whose size and shape can be neglected. It is viewed as mass point. If we talk about rigid body, then what itself we can understand. But for the better understanding as a technical point of view, then a body is said to be rigid if the relative distance between the particles of the body remain same before and after application of forces. If we'll call about deformable body, then from the word you can easily understand, but for the definition point of view, a body is said to be deformable if its size and shape changes under application of external force. Now, what is continuum? So, it is defined as an idealized body whose matter is assumed to be totally continuous, homogeneous, and non-porous. So, best example, surface of a wing of an aircraft. Okay, to understand the subject in depth, we required the fundamental knowledge about the principle of mechanics. So, under fundamental principle of mechanics, the elementary mechanics rests on a few fundamental principles based on experimental observation. Which are that fundamental principle for mechanics? This is I mentioned in this slide. First, parallelogram, law of forces, principle of transmissibility, principle of superposition of forces, Newton's first law of motion, Newton's second law of motion, Newton's third law of motion, and Newton's law of gravitation. So, as per that principles, we will go with the technical content. So, under parallelogram law of forces. If two forces acting simultaneously on a particle be represented in magnitude and direction by the two adjacent sides of a parallelogram, the resultant may be represented in magnitude and direction by the diagonal of the parallelogram which passes through their point of intersection. Dear students, focus on this law of force for parallelogram. This is very important. Based on that, we have to understand many theories. Now, principle of transmissibility. So, if a force acts at any point on a rigid body, it may also be considered to act at any other point on its line of action, provided the point is rigidly connected with the body. If we'll talk about principle of superposition of forces, then if two equal opposite and collinear forces are added to or removed from the system of forces, there will be no change in the position of the body. This is known as principle of superposition of forces. In your many exams, such things are asked. So focus on that, try to read and try to understand, as it's very simple. Newton's first law of motion, we all know during our school time. Everybody continues in a state of rest or uniform motion unless it is compelled to change that state by some external force. This law defines the nature or characteristic of force. If we discuss about the Newton's second law of motion, then this acceleration of body is proportional to the impressed force and take place in the direction in which the force acts. You can see force proportional to acceleration, here force F proportional to acceleration small a. So we can say that F is equal to ma, where m is the constant representing mass of body. This law helps us to measure a free quantitatively. Okay, if we'll talk about Newton's third law of motion, then we also studied it in our school time. What is Newton's third law of motion? Very easy. For every action, there is always an equal and opposite reaction, which means the forces of action and reaction between two bodies are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Now, what is a Newton's law of gravitation? So here, two bodies are attracted towards each other along the line connecting them with a force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Please read over here, try to see that figure. M1 mass is there, M2 mass is there, two bodies are there, they are interconnected. So based on that, if we'll discuss, then two bodies are attracted towards each other along the line connected them with the forces which is directly proportional to product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. So here, as per figure, as per this definition, you can see force F proportional to M1 M2 into 1 upon R square. Therefore, as per previous, F is equal to MA. So here F is equal to G into M1 M2 upon R square. Okay, so now you have to keep the term in your mind that what indicated which name. So M1 represent mass of body 1, M2 represent mass of body 2, R distance between two bodies, F force of attraction between two bodies, G, universal gravitational constant. The value is G is mentioned over here in Newton meter square per kilogram square. Now, as per the figure and definition, weight of the body can be defined with the help of law of gravitation. Weight of a body on Earth is defined as the force exerted by Earth on a body. For example, let capital M is equal to mass of Earth. Okay, small m, mass of body laying on Earth. Capital R is equal to radius of Earth, that we know 6.374 into 10 raised to 6 meter. F, capital F is equal to weight of the body. Okay, so here we can say that F is equal to G into M, capital M into small m upon capital R square. So by simplifying that, F is equal to mg. How F is equal to mg? Here I clearly mention that G is equal to capital G into capital M upon R square. The value of G is 9.81 meter per second square. That will be helpful to us to solve many problems in this subject. So based on that, we can say W is equal to M into G. So now there is a question, how we put over here W. So F is equal to weight of body, W we mention over here. So we can say W is equal to mg. Now we have to focus on fundamental units, because so many students lose their mark because of the lack of knowledge regarding the units. So dear students, focus on units because it will be helpful to you in many subjects. All the physical quantities used in engineering mechanics are expressed in terms of three fundamental quantities: length, mass and time. The unit of these fundamental quantities are called fundamental unit or base units. What is derived units? If the unit of some physical quantities are derived from fundamental units, such units are called derived units. Example, unit of area, velocity, acceleration, etc. Now, what is system of units? So, there are four system of units which are commonly used and universally recognized. So, which are these four system? First, second, third, fourth are FPS system, CGS system, MKS system, SI system. So what are the full form of these four methods? FPS system means foot pound second. Okay. CGS, centimeter gram second. MKS, meter kilogram second. SI, meter kilogram second. Okay. So here you can see all these terms are come under length, mass and time, right? So we have to see which are the vector quantities. So displacement, velocity, acceleration, momentum, moment, force, weight, angular displacement, angular velocity, angular acceleration, impulse. These quantities are vector quantities. Now we are interested to convert our units because during calculating the problem there are so many values will be given. So we have to convert unit of some values while calculating the problems. So we have to focus on conversion of units. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. 1 meter is equal to 1000 mm. Generally we can say 10 raised to 3 power mm. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 mm. 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. So 10 cube meter. 1 centimeter square is equal to 100 mm square. 1 meter square is equal to 10 raised to 6 mm square. Here 1 kgf is mentioned. So 1 kgf is equal to 9.81 newton, sometimes we considered as 10 newtons at some places and in some problems too. 1 kilonewton is equal to 10 cube newton. 1 mn is equal to 10 raised to 6 newton, or we can say 10 cube kilo newton. 1 gn is equal to 10 raised to 9 newton, or we can say 10 raised to 6 kilonewton, or we can say 10 cube mn. 1 megapascal is equal to 1 newton per mm square. 1 gigapascal is equal to 10 cube newton per mm square. 1 pascal is equal to 1 newton per meter square. 1 newton into meter is equal to 1 joule. 1 kilojoule is equal to 10 cube joule. 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per second is equal to 1 newton meter per second. 1 kilowatt is equal to 10 cube watt. 1 horsepower is equal to 736 watt. 1 degree is equal to pi by 180 radian. Now, if we'll talk about scalar quantities, okay, then length, distance, area, volume, time, work, mass, density, temperature, speed, energy, mass moment of inertia. These all quantities come under scalar quantities. Okay, so dear students, today in this fundamental introduction lecture, we have gone through basic terms, basic unit, basic law, basic definition. This lecture will be helpful to understand subjects like strength of material, like mechanics of solid, like solid mechanics. And based on this lecture, we will understand many subjects. From this lecture, many definitions asked in your end semester exam too. So I hope by using this lecture PPT, you will understand whatever I explain in PPT. Because whatever I want to convey to you, this is I already written in my PPT. So you can read PPT, you can go through this lecture, and you can prepare well for our upcoming lecture. Today's lecture is completed over here. In my next lecture, I will come with new concepts. Till that, study well, stay safe, take care, and all the very best.